Hello guys, this video tutorial is related to discriminant validity. As in the last video, I told you that discriminant validity is the extent that measures the uniqueness of each of the variable, and it means that customer satisfaction should be different from customer loyalty. It confirms that these constructs are not correlated with each other and are unique. So there are the three criteria that assess discriminant validity. First is Fornan-Larker, second is cross-loadings, and third is heterocrate-monocrate ratio, which is also called HTMT ratio. So this is the first criteria, Fornan-Larker, and it is assessed, or it can be checked by checking the values of the square root of AVE with the latent variable correlations. So it compares the square root of the AVE values with the latent variable correlations, specifically the square root of each construct should be greater than its highest correlation within any other construct. What does it mean? It means that these diagonal values, which is 0.924, is basically the square root of AVE. All the diagonal values are basically the square root of AVE. 0.890 is also the square root of AVE of ATMB, and 0.868 is the square root of AVE of ATOB, and similarly 0.851 is the square root of AVE of IMB. These values, these square root of AVE, should be greater than the corresponding column and the row. And these values, which is basically 0.562, is the value of the correlation in between ATMB and ATA. 0.490 is the correlation value of ATOP and ATA. So 0.924 should be greater in the column and in the row. So it is greater in the column and the row. Similarly, 0.890 should be greater in the column and the row. So 0.890 is greater in the column and it is also greater in the row. Similarly, 0.868 is greater in row and in column. Similarly, 0.851 is also greater in row and column, and so on. So if all the values are meeting the criteria, then you can check the other criteria to assess discriminant validity. That is cross-loadings. So this criteria is basically an indicator's outer loadings on the associated construct should be greater than all of its loadings on the other construct. So basically, all the loadings should be greater in its own construct. ATA should be greater in ATA cell. ATMB should be greater in ATMB cell. ATOB should be greater in ATOB cell. All constructs should be greater in its own cell or in its own construct. The last criteria, that is heterocrate monocrate ratio, is measured or checked that all the values of the table should be less than 0.9. So this is the results of HTMT. All these values should be less than 0.9. So if all the criteria are meeting the suggested values or suggested threshold conditions, so after this we can say that all the values are unique. ATA is not highly correlated with ATMB. All the values are unique and distinct from each other. Thank you so much.